Claire, nice to meet you. How are you doing?
Nice to meet you. How are you doing?
I'm great, thank you. Could you start by telling us a bit about this character and the dynamics there, the relationship between you and Dane's character?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, essentially from my end, the dynamic is very simple. I go to Columbia University and fall in love with him. I mean, it's. I think we always fall in love with the... with people who have aspects in their personality that we wish we had in ourselves. And, you know, Alan, as an introverted, kind of slightly reserved guy when he was a young man, would have looked at Lucian, who was, you know, no social situation was too big for him. He's bold and an expansive kind of character, and he would have just, like, fallen in love. It's very easy to see how it would have happened. And then, you know, the dynamic gets more complicated as Lucian tries to edge Alan out of his life, and you know, and there's a murder. There's loads that happens in this film. I can't simplify it enough, I'm afraid.
And you describe these characters as living poetically and then writing about it. Yeah. So what did you mean by that? Can you elaborate?
My English teacher used to say something that I always thought was fantastic, which was that there are two types of poets. There are people that write poetically about their lives, and there are people that live poetically and write about it. And these guys, that's what they did. They were, in a way, the hellraisers of their time. They were going around causing trouble and wanted to live the most, again, expansive, wild lives that they could. And then in documenting that, that formed the basis of their poetry, I suppose.
J.K. Rowling, she's exploring new elements of the Harry Potter world. What's your opinion on that, and would you consider a cameo, perhaps?
I'm not considering a cameo, but I'm very excited that she's doing it, and that there will be more for people to see.
Thank you.
No, it was the best script that I'd read at the time, and it's an extraordinary script. And you know, I met John and saw that he had an incredibly clear vision for his film and had utter confidence in him. And yeah, I knew I wanted to be a part of it.
Gay love scene, tricky to film, or was it just like...
It was like any other scene, really. Yeah, this wasn't... Yeah, I think everyone expects it to be like, oh, we freaked out. There was two naked men there. But, like, it really, like, I don't know. It wasn't... You just prepared for it like you prepared for any other scene and got on with it.
Did you research Ginsberg's work at all? Did that help the character?
More his life than his work, to be honest, because he hadn't written any of his... Well, very much of his work at that stage. I find it more useful just to look at his diary. And his diary in his teenage years is fantastically insightful and, you know, like, you get... I don't know, you get a sense that he is writing for posterity, like he's writing for somebody else to read it later, because he's very articulate and eloquent.